Hey guys, today we have a 2016 Mazda 3 that we're going to be working on. We're going to do the front brakes on it. I took it to the dealer. They wanted to charge me, I believe, $599 to do the front brakes. I'm going to show you guys the quote that they showed me, and then also I'm going to show you guys the receipts of how much I really paid for the parts. And everybody could do this themselves. If you look at it, I'm just going to loosen this up. And I know there's a bunch of videos on this stuff. I think two or three. And usually I watch like two or three videos before I work on a car, just to make sure, because you know, you learn tips and tricks from everybody. The little tip that my grandpa taught me when you're gonna take the wheel off, I didn't use the tool that comes with the car to take the lug nuts off. So I went ahead and just used a 13/16 socket, and then I used this wrench as leverage. You see that? Just kind of like a breaker bar. There you go, just to give you more leverage. So that's a little tip and trick that you'll learn from me. So I'm gonna get into it, and then we'll review it afterwards. But I'll just tell you, there's two 17 millimeter bolts back here. Go ahead and show this one here. There's one at the top and one at the bottom. You're gonna go ahead and remove both of those. Here, remove both of these. It might have some anti-lock. Oh, and don't forget to take off this little clip, so we'll get this the hose out of the way, and we won't ruin the hose. Give me a second. We'll just knock this out with a screwdriver real quick. There we go, and don't do that. So save the clip, okay? Just put it to the side. And now, push the line through, and then you can go ahead and free it up. And what we're gonna do is, once we take out those two 17 millimeter bolts right here, we're just gonna hang this with a zip tie right here, just to get it out of the way. All right, so let me get the zip ties real quick. So let's go this way then. There we go. I think they put that factory lock little gel on there to make them tight, so it won't loosen up during the vibration. There we go. So both of those are out. All right, so those two 17 millimeter bolts are out. And just be careful, don't let this drop or your socket. All right, and I'm gonna get my zip tie ready. So it drops pretty gently, so just be aware and try to catch it. Okay, so your brake pads are in here. We'll deal with that afterwards. So I saw a video where they did this separately, but the second video that I saw was a little bit, not better, but it was different. I gotta just zip tie this out of the way.
Oh.
So we'll do this. This will just hang out of the way. It kind of blocks the light a little bit, but it is what it is. So, down here on the rotor, super important, go ahead and get your WD-40 and shoot it inside your bolts here, and in here, and around here. No, actually around here. Because this thing is like baked on, and it's very difficult to get off. And that's one important step that I missed. So when I was hammering it, I accidentally hit one of these studs right here, and then just and it just messed up the whole bolt. So that's something I got to deal with later. When you're knocking it with the hammer, you just knock it right here. The brake pads you get from AutoZone, they had a lifetime warranty, so if you do your brakes yourself, you're not gonna have to pay for any brake pads. And if you take care of your rotors and you change your brake pads regularly, you're not gonna have any issues. You won't have to change your rotors as much. So for these, don't forget to spray them. You gotta spray them with the brake cleaner, which I have over here. So this comes with some kind of oily substance, you know, so it won't rust. So it's really important you do this part. Just get that stuff off of there. And try not to touch this as much as you can. This stuff dries like really quick. You don't even have to dry it, but you know, just help it along for time's sake. Checking to see if I got lucky and it's loose, but it's not, so you just... So I'm gonna be here for a while, and I'm not gonna bore you with this, but you just keep on banging. Let this soak in for a little bit, put some more if you want to, but eventually this is just all gonna pop off. All right, so we'll just stop this for now. Okay, so I just put this rotor back on just to show you guys. So when I sprayed the WD-40 in these little slots, it went all the way to the back. I just had to give it some time to soak, and I was able to knock it out. See what happens is right here, there's a lot of rust that forms right here and right here, and because of the heat, it gets stuck to this. So what a lot of people do, or some people do, and I recommend doing it, is put that anti-seize grease right here and right in the back. So when you put it on, the next time you go and change your rotors, it's just gonna be very easy to come off. It's not gonna fuse on. Other than that, that's it. You just take this off, and we're gonna go ahead and replace it with a new one. So this is just your Permatex anti-seize lubricant, and this is, you know, something you could pick up like at AutoZone or like O'Reilly's or something like that. And you just coat the back of it. Doesn't have to be a lot, but you could just use your finger. Because if you start using this, you're gonna get big old globs all over the place. And you don't really have to do this. One of the videos I saw, they just kind of took it off and put it back on, but you know, it's one of those mechanic places who don't really care about your car. They just want to get it out, in and out real quick. So, but if you take your time and do this for the next time, if you do it yourself, you're gonna be able to get it off a lot easier. Okay, don't forget, try not to get nothing on the surface right here. All right, let's put it back on. There's a little hole right here, so I just like to line it up like the other one was. There we go. Yeah, I don't know if that hose was meant specifically made to throw, put the WD-40 in there, but all right. So after this, what I like to do is just throw in a little nut right here just to hold it in place, and then we're gonna put the caliper back on there. And we'll fast forward a lot of these things. This brake shop should really take you about an hour at most. But I ran into a bunch of like little things that kind of delayed me on the other side. So because this is the first time I'm doing it on my car, so pretty much if I could do it, anybody could do it. 17 millimeters. Go ahead and pop this off. Okay. Don't really take that off. And then we're gonna put this back in. I know you guys are thinking like you didn't change the brake pads, but that'll be a little bit later. There we go. There we go. So it's just like a little liquid that you put on the red. So this is supposed to help it not come out, because there's a lot of vibration in the front, so it won't vibrate loose. And we'll just put this back on. There you go. Once you tighten it, it'll prevent it from slipping out. So you do that to the top, and then you do it to the bottom one, the 17 millimeter. Yeah. All right, so now your two 17 millimeter bolts are secure with the thread lock, right? So you're good there. Now we want to get a 13 millimeter bolt. We're gonna undo this 13 millimeter bolt, pull the caliper up, change the pads, put them back down.
Right, so remember, righty tighty, lefty loosey. There we go, done.
And I might do a short and throw it on TikTok or Instagram, not sure yet. Okay, so that pops off. And this is supposed to rotate up. Oh, pads are on too tight. Oh, there we go.
And just be aware, this can pop out a little bit, so when you go back and try to put this back on, you might have to like wedge it in a little bit. Okay, so this pops off. Okay, just like that. It exposes your brake pads. And we'll talk about your caliper here later. But that's pretty much it. Let me get the brake pads. We'll pop these off, pop the new ones on, and then we'll put the caliper back on.
Okay.
So, okay, these are the ones, there's still some meat on there, I don't know. The dealer told me I had warped pads. My other pads look fine. I don't know what that's about. Maybe people don't check their stuff. It is worn down.
It's enough warp.
But you know, it's got a little meat on it still. And they told me my rotors were warped, which is questionable, but whatever. Okay. Here are my pads. I think I still got one that's used here. So on some of the videos, they change all these clips out because they come here, they're brand new and everything, but these are in good shape, so I don't see any reason to mess with them. What I am gonna do is, as you see here, the brake pad has a little clip, so that's the only one you really have to put on. I mean, it is advisable to change everything. You know, I'm not a professional, so do what you want on your car. So let's look at this. We'll compare one to the other. Okay, so we go like this. You see these two little tabs? They kind of same. They look a little bit different, but it's okay. They fit the same way. So you just pop this little tab in. There. And then you want to use a little lubricant. So you're getting a squeeze. On the little corners right here, right there, here, there. You don't have to go crazy with it. Okay, remember, once you got grease on your hands, don't touch your rotors. So the same way it came in, it's the same way. Let me see. It should be like this. Yeah, it should be like this. Off. And you kind of have to angle this, just FYI, and see here. Okay, here we go. Should be. Should clip in like that. So same way it came out, same way it goes in. Okay? Pop this one out. Don't get my big face in there. There we go. So same thing. Find that little clip. Go. So new pad, all we gotta do is put that little clip in, okay? All right, don't forget to lubricate it. One of the guys that I saw on the video did this whole thing. The other guy just popped in the pads, so you know, you just do what you think is best for yourself. There, just a little bit goes a long way. There we go. I'm gonna just pop these in. There, okay, you see that? They're back on, that's it. Now, when you're gonna go slide this back on, since this has more meat, the brake pad has more meat on there, it's gonna be wider. So this is gonna hit against the brake pad. So what you wanna do is go ahead and compress this in. You could do that with a C-clamp and a piece of wood. Hold on, let me show right here. I better hurry up because I gotta go to a garage.
All right, here we go.
And this compresses the caliper. So when you go and turn your car on, pump the brakes a couple of times to get this caliper to expand. Okay, that's it. And like I said, this might hit here. And that's something that they didn't explain on one of the couple of the videos. It was a little bit smoother than they expected. Oh, here we go. What you gotta do is just go in here. Just kinda push it in a little bit. There we go. Put in your 13 millimeter. And that's it, guys. So all in all, this should take you about less than an hour if everything goes smooth, which most of the time it doesn't. But like these little tricks, as far as like, oh, see, that's rotating. You can use a little wrench to do that. So I'm gonna go get a wrench. Okay. There you go. So when you put this in, just slide the hose in right there and push this through. You see that? And there's a slot. So what you want to do is put your clip back on the slot and make sure it's seated before you guys leave. You can give it a little tap with your screwdriver or hammer. It should go in pretty easily. But that's it, guys. I've cleaned up your mess, of course, and then put the tire back on. But nuts, you're good. Once you start the car, go ahead and pump the brakes a few times, and that's pretty much it. So
put the tire back.
I haven't posted a video in a long time, so I'm gonna start posting at least one video a week and see if it brings value to anybody, and hopefully this works. This job saved me about $300 for the front brakes. So, and I'll show you the breakdown on what they quoted me, and then I'll show you the stuff that I bought. Alright? So thank you guys, hope this helps. Catch you guys on the next one.